Hi guys, a very good morning to all of you, and I hope you all are safe. Maybe excited for my class, so I am here to teach you SST Standard 4, Chapter 7, and the chapter name is Our Natural Resources, Forests and Wildlife. So today we will finish the chapter. It's the last topic that we will see in this today's online class. And then after, in second videos, like in lecture number 2, I will give you the exercise so that you can complete the exercise new words in your fair copy. And I request all of you to please stay at home and enjoy your quality time with your family members. You can enjoy like playing the Ludos, Carom, video games. In fact, you can complete your homework which you received on online classes. Please complete it in good handwriting, legible handwriting, and use the dark pencil. I want good handwriting, and if you have a lots of time, so please use the time and please complete all the homework, because I have all the records. So once the school will open, I just want all the homework, and you have to show me all homework in good handwriting, and it should be in legible handwriting. So please write down if you have a lots of time, so please use the time. And please don't go outside, don't interact with other person, because it's very serious, a very dangerous virus. Because of this virus we can die also. So for protecting us and for our families, be safe at home. Don't go outside, don't interact with the other person, just stay at home, attend the online classes, and you can complete your holiday homework. In fact, you can read the book also. Once then online class will over, then you can write your homework also. And if you have not completed your holiday homework, then please complete it and project work, because these all marks, it will add in your term 1 exam. So I want everything, because it's a lots of time, so please complete it, all the homework which work is pending. I hope you guys had completed your healthy and delicious breakfast. So eat healthy and stay happy at home, and whenever you are going to eat your meals, please wash your hand properly so that the germs will not enter in your body and it will kill. And please, whenever you are going to eat your meals, please wash your hand properly so that we will save from the COVID-19. And eat healthy, spend your time with family members, you can attend the online classes, you can read the chapter, you can learn the objective types, and you can complete your holiday homework. So, and I will start from the first topic in this chapter, chapter 7, and then we will see that what we have learned in earlier classes from this chapter, starting from the starting. So we will take a short look from this chapter, and I'm just going to read and I'm just going to explain you. So please be careful, listen carefully, and if you have the book, then read with me. So in this chapter, we have learned, first of all, we have learned about the natural resources. What is natural resources? In junior class, like from standard 1, you have learned that the things which gives from the nature, that is a natural resources. So in this chapter, it is also defines like that nature has gifted us. Nature has gifted us lots of things. Nature has gifted us a lots of things, such as air, water, forest, soil, mineral, and wildlife. So these things are called natural resources. We totally depend on these resources for our daily needs. Now we have two types of natural resources. The first is exhaustible and the second is inexhaustible. Exhaustible we can also called non-renewable resources, and inexhaustible we can also call renewable resources. Two words but the same meanings. Now what is exhaustible resources? The resources which are limited and which get reduced in quantity as they are used are called exhaustible, or it is also called non-renewable resources. Like example, coal, petroleum. It is exhaustible resources, natural resources. Now, what is inexhaustible resources? Now that we have some sources like the air, water and sunlight, we have always available, it is always available in plenty in nature. So resources like forest and animals, it can be renewed. So these sources are called inexhaustible, or we can say the renewable resources also. About the forest resources, forest is very important for us. It gives us a lot of things. It provides us a lot of things in our daily needs. Like first of all, what is forest? Then a forest is a large area of land thickly covered with trees. In India, we have 1/5 of the land is covered with land, with covered with forest. It is very useful natural resources, and it gives us many things. Like suppose it gives us oxygen to breathe, then it makes the soil, trees makes the soil very fertile. It provides us food and fruits. It gives us things. They gives us timber. With the help of timbers, we can make a different types of product like furniture, houses, matchsticks and paper. Sometimes some plants also provide medicines like the neem, then tulsi, many different types of trees are there. Then it also trees also used in villages to cook food. Then it gives us shelters to the forest gives us shelter to the animals, to the birds. Without forest, the animals would not have the place to live. And we have a different types of forest resources. Different types of forest resources like evergreen forest, deciduous forest, thorny and shrub forest, mountain forest, then tidal forest. Now about the evergreen forest, I have explained earlier that it is like a green throughout the year. Evergreen forests are green throughout the year. These are a dense forest in the area. Now some important trees it is found in the evergreen forest like sandal, rosewood, ebony, mahogany and bamboo. These are the trees which we can find in the evergreen forest. Next, second is about the deciduous forest. It is also called a monsoon forest. Deciduous forest we can also called monsoon forest. Here different types of trees also find, that is called teak, sal, mahua, simul and sandalwood. It is found in the different states like Bihar, Madhya Pradesh, Odisha, Uttar Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Tamil Nadu. Sandalwood is also found in Kerala. Next, trees about the thorny and shrubs. It is generally found in the deserty areas of Rajasthan. And some dry states, some dry areas of Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra, Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh. Here some trees, only few trees we can find like kikar, babul and date palm. We can found in the desert areas because they have a very long roots. So they can just go deep inside and underground the water, and they just take the water because there is a scarcity of water. So that's why it can survive. These tree can survive without water, little amount of water for many months. So that's why these trees are grown in that forest. Next, about the last types of forest is mountain forest. Mountain is always covered with snow, so there is no vegetation, means there is no plants can grow because of the snow, because of the temperature. So when you will come some downs, then we can see that some few smaller shrubs are there, and again if we can go some lower, then we can see the coniferous forest. The coniferous forest, it is like a tree that are tall and cone shaped. Tall and cone shaped with needle like leaves. We can find different types of trees in the coniferous forest like cheer, deodar, pine and spruce. Next and last forest is the tidal forest. It is the forest also called the mangroves. Tidal forest is also called the mangroves. These forests are dense and the trees are very hard wood. The Sundari trees is a well-known trees which grows in the Sundarbans. The Sundari trees, it is a one trees which is grown in the Sundarbans. It is very important which are the mangroves forest, and it is found in the West Bengal and Bangladesh. Now about the next topic, conservation of forest, that we will see in the next videos. So please guys, watch the next videos and please be continue, because in the next video I will give you the exercise. So please just listen the online class till last. Take care of yourself. Thank you and have a nice day.